Okay. Let's see what we can do. The one on the right is quillless, and the one on the left is quilled. So I'm hoping this will be a good pairing. I think it will. I hope you're doing well today, Gio. Thanks for dropping in. I just want to get a background down so we can see him a little better here. More quill dogs to spend money on. Also, more potential breeding partners. Yes. Good morning, Mint Poppy. Right? I think they're beautiful too. they're very contrasting from one another, but I think that'll actually be nice. So I think what I'm gonna do, since she's so long, I'm gonna kind of hide her tail. I think that'll be all right, because we know it's blue and navy and black. It came a little bit bigger behind his tail here too. So we still get the gist of what they look like, but it won't take up so much space vertically. Then the quill. The flames will be so fun, yes. And the one on the right is actually quillless. They don't have quills. That's like light and magic coming out of holes in their back. So getting to work with that will be fun. Oh, I forgot to turn notifications off. Let me do that real quick. Yes, I might do that, Gio. So, I'm just kind of setting everything up first here. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about this pairing. I think it'll be a lot of fun. Ha ha ha. Especially also, Relic's got some little bony appendages and a skull face and a lot of different traits to get to work with. Hi, Ninja! Puppies, yes. Geo, yes, it's. I think it's very fun. I think this pairing is gonna be great. I love how contrasting they are. They're so different, so they're both gonna lend amazing, amazing different traits. So. I think what I'm going to do first is get a fresh canvas and we'll draw up some pup lines. I'll get this one saved. Let's see. Ninja, fox, litter.sci. Save. So I'm going to just start with a canine base, and then when I go through and make all the different trait changes, that's when I'll add in the things like the transparency and the bony paws and the head and stuff like that. Oh, Luna and I are happy to put them together. That's awesome. They're they're an awesome pairing. I really like them. And you guys said to surprise you with a number. I know we had discussed like 10 or 12, so. Also, it is very stormy and windy here. So if you hear any background noise, it is most likely the rain and wind outside. So, just a little heads up. I really can't. It has rained and stormed like for the past 3 solid days. Oh, Ninja, thank you. Excited to see the lines. I am too. I never know how exactly I'm going to make them myself. Like, I usually have an idea, and sometimes it'll come through, and then sometimes it'll be what I don't expect. Because you can start in one direction and then your art just goes in another, and it's just what it is. That's okay. I think I'm going to make these paws a little bit smaller. A little more nimble. Oh, okay, Gio. I understand. I appreciate you stopping by. if you're tuning in, I am working on a commissioned litter from Ninja Fox C3 and LunaOlwen. And basically, their characters, like one of each of their characters, is being used as a parent. And I get to create some puppies. So it should be a fun time. I always like making litters. It's always fun to get to play around with the different traits of each parent. And being magical, we don't have the same restrictions as we do in real life. So we can just play around and see what we get. Yeah, I hope you're having a good day. It is Friday, so that's always a good thing. Tomorrow I've got a D&D in our house, so my husband is actually the DM. So he's got me hooked on D&D now. Okay, so they both have long tails, so we can include that. I play a druid. my last character was a half-elf druid, and this time I'm playing a tabaxi druid. So I love druid. I love the wild shape, especially. That is my favorite part. Like, it's the class that has always appealed to me the last, I don't know, year or two I've played. I just love it. Oh, awesome, awesome. You too. Like, I think like some of the classes are kind of cool, but that one's just the one that's always has stood out to me and what I've enjoyed so far. Yes, you don't have to talk much when you're an animal. I really like using the blink dog because you can teleport on your turn, and I love it. It's one of my favorite wild shapes that I've come to learn. Mm-hmm, I love it. And, like, just getting to, like, look at the different descriptions of each animal and be like, okay, how can I use this to my advantage in a fight, you know, with or whatever situation I'm in with my comrades. Just trying to think outside the box, and I love it. Oh, that's so cool. You get to be a griffin. Yeah, I think our last campaign, we, let me think. Did we get to level 9? Level 9 or level 10? I'd have to look back at my notes, but it was so fun getting to play some of those higher level creatures. Because, like, right now we're all at, like, we just started a new campaign this year. So we're all at, like, level 3. It's going to be a little while. But, man, I love D&D now. It's, it is appealing. It is fun. It is, like, getting to explore a fantasy world and getting to adventure with friends and... I always look forward to it. We have ours like every other weekend. So, and this is our on weekend, our D&D weekend. So, should be fun. There we go. Not a bad tale. Oh. You know someone whose character was a seal? That's funny. A mage seal. Okay, so there was a moment in our last campaign where we were entering a pyramid. And Solo, my husband, he's the DM, he was like, okay, you walk up to the pyramid and you notice there's a seal. And our rogue went up to investigate the seal, and our DM's like, it is an elephant seal. And it barks at you. And our rogue just lost it. It was hilarious. It's one of my favorite memories from last campaign. Like, there's just an elephant seal guarding this door. Okay, Gio. You take care. Thanks for stopping by. I think it'll probably be easier to do a side profile with the head, especially if I'm wanting to do some skeleton heads, skull heads. I think I want to change that. Oh, okay, Mint. I see you in a little while. Have a good meeting. I'm really liking these lines so far. I think they're working. Yes, I think so too, Ninja. Especially if we're gonna do skulls and stuff like that. It'll be easier to alter it, you know, on this type of angle. Yeah. And then taper his nose just a little bit more. There we go. I'm a fan of snatched. a snatch nose. I don't know. What do they call it? Snipey nose. Okay, get some fur added. Actually, I think I might make the head just a little bit bigger. I think that. Yeah. Now, if you're just tuning in and you don't normally watch my art, I usually start with a blue base to get my fur detail and fur texture in. So just a little heads up that these colors will most definitely change. Just, I always like starting with a neutral blue. Just how I do it. It's a little weird, but it works for me. So. Yeah, if you're listening in and you happen to have any comment or question, feel free to put it in the Twitch chat, and once I see it, I'm happy to reply. Yes, Ninja, I totally agree. Just to get some of those basic shapes down. And then I just manipulate it from there. And it usually works. Now some of these are going to have fire. Some are going to have quills, some are going to be quillless with light and magic. Let me think. Some will have semi-transparent bodies. There'll be some with skeletal paws and skulls for heads. There's going to be a fair amount of variation here going on. Because mom and dad are a little bit different from one another. And that is A-okay. Spice of life. Variety is, you see. Yeah. I'm excited, Ninja. I think this is a cool pairing. You guys chose some great characters to pair up. And I've been wanting to make pups for Relic for a while. He's so cool. And Aleu's like one of my favorite designs that I've drawn. I just love her blues. Like, honestly, they're both amazing. I just, I'm getting to like revisit them. I'm just like, yes. Makes me happy. And I felt like since both parents are fairly dynamic in their poses, I wanted their kiddos to have a nice dynamic pose. I feel like we've achieved that here. Yes, light and dark. I love it. And like blue and red, or warm and cold. There's so much going on and I love it. Ooh, it's windy outside. Like, hear it. So I'm on a walking challenge where I'm walking every day of the month, and this morning it was storming, and we finally had a break in this storm, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna like get out, get my 2 miles in, and come back home and be okay. Halfway through, like on the radar, it looked great. Like, okay, I had like an hour, so surely I can get that all done. And went outside with Rosie. We're halfway through our walk, and it starts raining on us. It's like, no. So, like, we race home. But we are good and fine. We got our walk in today. We got our miles in, so it's all good. I'm definitely feeling like a warm shower later will be very nice because I got soaked. But that's all right. Little rain never hurt anybody. And next week, I'm hoping I can work on our spring event coming up. I do have a commission Monday or Tuesday. I'd have to look at my schedule, but other than that, I'm really hoping to devote some good time to working on stuff for the spring event. So that should be fun. Ooh, I should probably save this too, huh? Up. I know on my screen I just had ads. So I apologize if you've had them too. I know a lot of times mine will align with other people's when they run, so. Gonna extend this leg out just a little bit. Well, just a tad bit short. There we go. Yeah. Oh, thank you. I shall save my work. Appreciate the reminder. Okay. Ninja Fox. Upline. Save. Okay. I have saved. Thank you. I appreciate it. Oh, I'm totally bad about saving. And congratulations on your first time in chat. Myrways or Myrways? I hope I'm saying that right. If I'm not, please feel free to correct me. Oh, well, thanks for popping in. I know DA is where I feel most prominent as far as art and where I've submitted a lot of stuff and focused a lot of interest in. But I figure if I'm drawing most days, might as well share the experience and the progress via Twitch. So hi Quill, I hope you're doing well. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, And congratulations on your first chat here, too. It's exciting. Also, if you hear me bump my microphone, it's because when I draw, I lean in real close to my canvas. And I'm left-handed, and my microphone's on the left side of my headset here. And so I just lean in and boink. I hit it pretty often. So if you hear any weird little microphone boinks, that's my hand accidentally hitting it. Oh, I'm glad you're doing all right. It is Friday, so can't be too bad of a day, right? I am working on another commissioned litter. So it's fun getting to bring these two designs together and see what they will produce magically. Yes, I love Fridays too. Because with my art, I try to keep my work minimal on the weekends. I try to give myself a break just so I don't have like hand cramping and, you know, stuff like that. So Saturdays and Sundays are kind of my day off. So it's always nice to get out and go fishing and visit family and friends. And like this weekend we have D&D, so that'll be fun. But yeah. All right, I think we've got a decent base going on here. See how many I can fit on our litter chart. Save real quick first. Oh yes, I'm gonna definitely have to extend our canvas, but that is not a problem. Yes, D&D. My husband is actually a DM, so he got me introduced to D&D, and I love it. I love it. I play a druid, and the last campaign I also played a druid. I really like the druid class. But last campaign I was a half-elf druid and with an outlander background, and this campaign I am a tabaxi druid with a archaeologist background. So I'm basically a librarian cat with glasses. Yes, we're definitely going to have to extend this canvas if I want to at least fit 10 or so. But that's no problem. Yeah, her name is Wing, my librarian cat. Yes. I think Ninja and Luna had mentioned 10 or 12 and gave me the option to surprise them. So I shall surprise them. That is no problem. Yeah, I'm still gonna have to extend it a little more if I wanna. 7, 8. I wanna do 10 or 12. Oh, that's fine, Quill. I look forward to working with you on a commissioned letter someday. Ninja Fox, yes! I'm gonna surprise you guys. Let me see. Let me see what I could do here. Chain size. 1,000. Keep dragging it down. We're gonna fit them in there yet. Oh my goodness. Okay. Copy. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, ten. Wahahaha. All the doggos. Okay, I'm gonna save this before I lose it. Ninja Fox litter dot sci. Okay. Now, fun part, getting to mess with all their traits. Well, first things first, I'm gonna give some of them real quills. Copy this layer a couple times so I have my originals if I need it. And some of them might have a combination of real and magical quillless. Some of these are going to have these little skull heads. I think I'm going to leave them uncolored for now. So we have options. Okay. The printer on the desk behind me, Solo's desk, started randomly making noise. I'm like, a little creepy. Like, out of nowhere. Like, I'm not printing anything. It's a ghost. Maybe this one's just got it on the front pole. For difference. Okay, Ninja, I'll see you later. Lukina, hi. Yes, you made it in time to see the pups being made. We've got a lot involved with these parents. We got cooler tones and warmer tones and fire and bones and skulls and quilled and quillless and got a lot going on. So. I'm going to save. Hi, Luna. Yes, babies. I love your guys' pairing. Yes, bird says hi. I think so too, Lukina. There's just so much. I love it. I think what I'm going to do is try and get some base colors down first. And then we'll come back in with these skulls and claws and the transparency and the glow and fire and everything. So, first things first, some base colors. So, we definitely need a nice blue one. Maybe this one is a more gray toned. Dad. Maybe there's one that is the color of the bones, that stark white, yellow white. Of course, different shades of blue here. Got the fiery colors we can play with too. Maybe this one's more of a blue tone. Maybe that gold color markings we can. Oh, they're such a sweet pairing too. I love their relationship. What's their little backstory? Do they have a backstory? Oh, okay, Luna. Okay. Okay. Got some base colors in. Oh, thank you, Lukina. Lou wanted to befriend Relic and the friend. Well, I wish she came up behind him because of the flash out. Oh. Oh, that's so cute. Oh, Luna, I love that. I'm also the type to love, like, super slow building romance. I think it's really adorable. It kind of reminds me of Solo and I's coming together. Like, we talked for months, and I didn't go out on a date with him until, oh goodness, like, we started talking in May. We didn't go on a date till September. I was still in grad school. So. Thank you for sharing the backstory. I appreciate it. I'm glad you like them, Luna. I tried to get a variety going. So. Okay, I think it's time to add some quillis quills. Oh, I have to save. Studio, hello. I hope you're doing well today. Hi. Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. Oh, thank you. I'm just getting started on the will-less light magic stuff. I don't know what to call it. Will-less light magic stuff. Sounds official, doesn't it? Oh, you're fine, Mint. Boar looks so eerie, I love. Oh, he kind of does, doesn't he? The colorings on three look similar to childhood cat. Oh, already pulling on my heartstrings. Oh, that's so sweet. I love it. I was thinking with this one, we could do fire colored quills or quillless magic, rather. So the ends of the quills kind of just fade into nothingness, because it's supposed to be like rays of magical light. And the base will get a little orange. Then we can define that. The yellow kind of popping up again. Oh, the reds. Yes, I know. I can't help myself. I love the reds. Especially with dad's fire. That'll be fun. He really does. Both of them do, really. Yes, I was so excited to see if when we get the flamey disco butt. Yes! Flamey disco butt included. Okay, I think we have the quills and quillus figured out. Going to just bump up some of the glow. Some of them. Mom has some serious glow going on, so I'm gonna mimic that in a couple of them. Disco butt. That is a official term now. Oh, I'm just kidding. Okay. So he's got kind of teal and yellow eyes. She's got blue and white. So for the eyes, we can pretty much mess with teal, yellow, blue, white, or eye colors. The fact that one of them kind of looks like a beach meeting an ocean is tugging on my heartstrings. Oh, the mission was on the beach. That's precious. I love it. I'm just chilling on Beach Child. So we've got markings and fire and some semi-transparency with the skeleton boy. I think I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to go through and give some of them a little bit of a translucent skeleton. So that's what we're going to work on now. Just like a suggestion of what's there. We don't want to go too far into detail. I think that looks nice. You name with his little skeleton, huh? Maybe this one's got a little orange. Gillington. Maybe this one, the skeleton only shows up in the blue part of the fur. Something like that. I think I'm going to bring in some fire, and then after that we will do markings and shimmer and sparkles and decor. We got fire, markings, shimmer and sparkles, and decor. And then they'll start shaping up. Just gonna make a fire. It won't end up this color on this design. Fire. Oh, thank you, Luna. I appreciate that. I think they're starting to come together. I think we're gonna be able to make some pretty babies here. I'm going to try and pull some of these quills to the front. So it kind of looks like embedded. Yeah, I think maybe this one, the fire coming off of. A little more muted, yellowed. Ninja's muted, I think, so I'm gonna type. Oh, I better save. There we go. Maybe we can get darker colors here. Yeah, I think. Maybe this one has fire. The his tail. I have to rein in that glow so it's not touching the other guy. I think this one I might leave without fire. Maybe he's got fire coming. Oh wow, that's a cool flame color. Thank you, Mint. You're certainly going to make it hard to pick. Sorry, Ninja. Oh, sorry, Luna. Yes, 12 to choose from. That's a lot. A lot of decisions to make. Fire in his tail. I think I might keep flameless as well. This would cover it. Okay. Maybe this one's got flames underneath its body. That up through the chest here. We can cut out the shoulder. Show that definition, but kind of fade up there. Here's where we're at so far. We still need to do the markings and decor in shimmer sparkles. We're almost there. Getting some good variants. So, mom's got shimmer and sparkles pretty much all over, especially on the tail and legs. So I want to go through and introduce that to some of these designs. Then we'll do markings and decor. Then names, then need to make files, and parents will get to pick, then be on our way. The descriptions too, I'll have to do. We've got a little ways to go yet, but we're getting there. Sparkles and flames, I love it. Ooh, there's a few that are catching Ninja's eye. Exciting. Yeah, this is pretty much my my process of making designs. I just randomize the parents' traits and apply it to different puppies. And I try to utilize what I think looks good and appropriate for each one. Sometimes it turns out. And sometimes it's a swing and a miss, but that's okay. On some of these, I might go more heavy with the sparkle, and on others, I might go a little more light. And then Dad's got these like diamond markings. Decor, or whatever you'd like to call it. Diamond accent. I'm going to go through now. They always turn out well. Thank you. The stars and diamonds are too cute. I know, I love them together. I think they look really nice. I think this one we should embrace that white. Give her some white little sparklies. Stars. Of course, we haven't put in actual markings yet. So they still have a little ways to go. I love this combination of teal and orange. I think it's just great. So pretty. Maybe this guy's got more of the little diamond. Diamonds. Diamonds. Of an accent. Hands here. Creepy crawly fingers. I'm going to embrace the fire colors on this one. I'm going to try and keep this guy's a little bit more minimal. Oh, thank you, Mint. Yes. I love that shade of teal. I think it works well with a lot of different colors, too. There we go. Just a simple this guy. I think we're going to grab some of that navy and do some navy bits. Star. Maybe a couple diamonds. If you're listening in, do you have a favorite yet? I know we're not done with him yet, but I know some people have mentioned that they currently have some favorites. So feel free to share in the chat below if you're willing to express that publicly. I know some folks like to save their favorites until after they've bid, which I totally understand. Going to embrace this really bright, super light blue dye. Diamonds and hearts. I love this off-yellow gold color against the tealish blue. I think it's pretty. I think it works. navy dark color too. It looks Is all of them an appropriate answer? Yeah. The black one with purple pink vibes. Hellhound. Yeah, I can see that. I can definitely see that. I tried to make this one have paws that were different from each other. Cute little off-colored paws. I think the stars might be a little bit too. There we go. Oh, Yang, you've been lurking. I'm gonna Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave. We're getting somewhere. I think if I had to choose like an actual narrowed down selection, I love 1, 6, and 9.
Ooh, okay.
1, 6. I see, yeah. Nice. Okay. Now we're going to try and incorporate some markings. So Dad really doesn't have a ton of actual markings. He has some here and up on his neck and some of these arm bands. His face has got a little bit of linear markings. Oops. Let's just start with the go from there. Dad has some floating. He's got some floating diamonds. Head and some sometimes around his feet. Did we make that the same color? Got some line details. Oh, thank you, Luna. I'm really trying to push myself this year and see how well I can do. This is a big old litter too, dang. Yes, yes, Yang. It is. 12 new babies. Which means 10 new auctions for anyone interested. floaties. Okay, I think I'm going to leave this guy without the thingy. This guy I want to add. Yeah, Mitch, it's been a very busy week. And more masterless work for Yang, yes. Sorry, Yang. All pure quill. Yes, they're all pure quill. Yes, ML. Whenever you see a mod reference ML. It's most likely masterless. I think this is what this guy needed, was a little third accent color. I'm gonna put some little thingies in his quills. Just because. Yeah, that's what he needed, a third accent. Oh, thank you, Mint. I appreciate the effort, Yang. Bird Studio. I need the burb to select a pup. I was thinking next month with the litter about doing, or we could do it, but in the March, I've not done March litter yet, have I? Next litter that's not commissioned. I was thinking about having a solo pick parents. I saved, I promise. Ooh, 2, 8, 9, and 10. Ooh, yes, let's do it. Now, I don't know what he would choose. He'd probably choose much differently than me, just because he's got different tastes and stuff. So it could be really interesting. It's just a matter of sitting him down and making him choose. Yeah. Very random. When I've asked him for prompts in the past, he's always come up with some pretty good ones, so. He's a very creative guy. So, you wouldn't know it just looking at him. He's very creative, though. Especially with his D&D campaign stuff. He loves it. He's amazing with that kind of stuff. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Lukina. I shall hydrate. And Bert agrees. Ten out of ten, good egg. Yes. He is a very good egg. Burp. Oh my goodness. So last year or the year before, my husband and my parents and my husband's grandpa all went to a black powder rendezvous, which is like a it's kind of like a Civil War era and beyond like fair. And anyway, there was a very large rooster at this black powder rendezvous, and my mom, bless her heart, she's amazing, but she saw this chicken, this humongous rooster, and she's like, bird, and she's like, just across the way, the bird. I'm like, mom, that's a chicken. She's like, oh. It just, every time somebody says burb, that's what it reminds me of. My mom, just like, yelling across the way at a chicken. Yeah, that black powder rendezvous was very cool. It like there were a lot of people in costume, a lot of period type of educational events. So there were like people flint knapping, which is like making arrowheads, and there were like axe throwing competitions and like actual black powder work going on, which is like the older style of guns. Oh goodness, there was so much. There was like amazing little shops and like leather tanneries, that kind of stuff. Woodworking, all of it. Butter making, soap making. Chickens are birds. I think so. No, they're government drones, right? Oh. Yes, birds aren't real. I fly a drone. My falcon is not real. He is fake. Maybe a couple little diamonds on this guy. Coming together. Okay. Try and replicate his main mark. put it on his neck. Different. Maybe it trails onto his tail here. We'll do it in a gray. A bit more muted. There we go. If I have time, I might mint. It'd probably be after the spring event, because that's my next main thing I want to finish up. And yeah, if I get the time, I will most certainly try. If not, April for sure, because I do have a spring background in mind that I want to do. So. Okay. There's Dad's markings on some of the pups. Now Mom's got some fun ones too. She's got the moon and a star on her head. Circular stuff going on. With that. Oh, Luna, what should I sing? I don't want to get copyright struck. Sing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how I wonder what you are. It does fit with the set. That's perfect. I didn't even think of that. I think now what I'm going to do is go through and refine each one, add a little more markings and some decor. Bravo, thank you. Oh, I feel so accomplished. I think this one I'm gonna try some of Mama's markings on here. Pretty little orbital armbands and the particular head marking. Not perfect, but that's. White under the eye. Oh, excuse me. It's rain snowing. Oh man. Thank you, Mitt. Bless. Yes, people north of us are getting snow, but we actually got a we got storms. Oh, thank you, Lukina. Gonna go through and finish up each one here. Getting to that point, guys. After this, we'll get to name them. Now, since these are quillless, I don't really want to try and add any decor directly to them because it's just light. But I think we'll be like this. Maybe he's got a little hole in his skull here. Patch some. There we go. Yes. We've got 1 out of 12 done. Oh, thank you. Yes, I enjoy the concept. I'll be honest. Maybe this one's got some armbands from Mama. Two. Back leg here. In between. She inherited from Dad. There we go. Maybe this one's got a nose ring. All the danglies. It's been a while since I've done a nose ring. All right, we got two done. Yeah. Woo. Let's start from the bottom here. We'll work our way up. Jumping around always helps me. Maybe some of Mama's circular markings. Neck. Head. Maybe he's got a little bit of a lunar mark. Some of Mom's circular Mercury going on. There we go. All right, we're 3 out of 12, guys. 9 to go. When it comes to decor time, they usually go fairly quickly. Since we got most everything else. Definitely want to add a little moon marking. Dots. Maybe a little moon under the eye here. For good measure. And the moon. Little moon on the ear dangly. Yep. Okay, 4 are done. So this one as just quillless, finagle jewelry off other parts of the body. Maybe he's got a little tail bands here. Oh yeah, that looks nice, I think. This one, I'm definitely feeling the teal color against this sandy. Maybe it just sits here on the bottom. Or maybe it's connected. Maybe he's got a lower set little circular mark. On. Lunar markings. The eye. Oh, thank you, Mint. Have a good lunch. Thanks for dropping by. All right, we got 6 left to finish, and then we're going to do names. And then I will start working on files and descriptions. They're almost done, Yang. I'm working on their decor. Their decor and a couple little markings yet. Mom's got like that sick circular marking. I like to try and add some type of little circular reference to some of them. I've been streaming for 3 hours so far, so. But once I get everything like in place and going, it goes relatively quickly. But yeah, it definitely feels fast. Maybe this one's got that lunar marking from Mom here on the neck. Eye up on the neck. Star. Some of those little things. Oh, thank you, Luna, for subscribing. Oh wow, that went by fast. It did. It did. We have been streaming for over 3 hours. And to me it's gone by very fast. Which I don't mind. They say time flies when you're having fun, right? So we must be having fun. Little lunar markings here from mom. Maybe a couple little offset moons that also mimic that circular marking. She's got a little X on her. Oh, my hand is fine. Thank you. I promise it's okay. It is much better than the other day. It will definitely appreciate the break this weekend, though, I think. It has been a very drawing intensive week, which I've had a lot of fun with. But it's always good to give yourself a break too. And I've learned this a lot. It's easy to go overboard. I think I'm gonna put a little moon under her eye, Mama. Maybe one up here. Kinda encompasses her. Then think they're done, guys. I just gotta give them names. So here, I'll give a close-up shot here of each one. I'll scroll slow. Save. NinjaFoxLitter.sci. Now let's get some names. Names and numbers. We got one. We have Aleu and Relic to work with for name. Relu. I love it. Two. Ulrich. We have Relu and Ulrich. Or Alec. I can make one of them Alec. I'll do the third one, Alec. Four. Two. Eli. Leu. Leu. You were trying to think of names earlier. We could do UEL. R-I. Jewelry. Jewelry. Six. Bill. Gallery or Aylery? Eight. And of course, if you end up owning one of these designs, you are welcome to change the name. These are just ideas for whoever happens to acquire them. Okay, Eiler. Tyler. Three more. And Huey. I think that's a cute name, Yui. Rely? R-E-L-I? Rely? And our last one. Lou. L-E. Lou. Pure. I think you meant to say cute. Or is that a name idea? Pure. P-U-R-E. That could have been a good one. Alright, guys, I think they're done. Ah, oh my goodness. I really like this litter. I think it come together well. So what I'm going to do is hop off of here. Oh, the afternoon naps hit me. I'm going to hop off of the stream and work on making files and descriptions. And then Luna and Ninja and Sophie, you all will have the chance to choose your first picks. And once those are confirmed, the remainder will be posted to DeviantArt. And put it for auction. So, thank you. Thank you, Lukina. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, guys. And I will see you Monday. So, hopefully these will be either posted today or tomorrow, depending on parent picks. But, yeah, we'll see what happens. So, all right, I'm going to turn off the stream now, but thank you so much for hanging out, and I hope you have a great weekend, and see you Monday. I'll be here Monday. Bye, guys.